Hello future makers, welcome to Teacherpreneur. A person's name is to him or her the sweetest and the most important sound in any language. And in today's video, we are going to see how to remember the names of students. As a teacher, it is very important for us to have a personal connection with the students in the classroom. And one very important factor in this is remembering the name of the student. So let's get started with how to remember the names of the students in interesting ways. The first amazing activity that we can play with the kids is to tell them to complete the sentence, when you think of dash quality, think of me. This is a very interesting activity wherein kids will come up with very interesting answers, like when you think of dance, think of Ayush. When you think of Vedic maths, think of Rugved. This will be an interesting thing. You will also know the name of the student. You will also know the important quality that the kids will possess. It will be very easy for you to remember names. The second game that we can play with the kids to remember their names is a memory game. Usually kids play memory game, but in this activity, it's time for the teacher to play the memory game. The interesting activity can start with the sentence, I went on a picnic with. And after that, you can tell the name of each and every student and make it like a memory game until you remember the last name. You can also keep a twist, as in every time you miss the name of a student, the student can get up and help you. So this can go like, I went on a picnic with Riddhi. I went on a picnic with Riddhi and Twinkle. I went on a picnic with Riddhi, Twinkle and Mahima. I went on a picnic with Riddhi, Twinkle, Mahima and Nirmiti, and so on. This will be very interesting and you will enjoy the class as well as you will remember maximum names, believe me. The next concept is that of forming associations with the name but with a twist. Yeah, the twist is that the student should try and describe their name in two words, wherein the second word will be his name and the first word will be a quality that starts with the first alphabet of his name. For example, I will describe my name as Khyati. So the second word becomes Khyati and the first word should be a quality that describes me. Let's say Khoobsurat. So my name becomes Khoobsurat Khyati. In a similar manner, we can have Guy Kevin, Dashing Darshan and so on. This will be really fun and believe me, if you do this activity in the classroom, the next time you see the kid, you will always remember him as Kind Kevin and not just Kevin. Another thing that you can do as a teacher in the classroom is grouping all the students according to the first alphabet of their name and then letting them tell their names so that it's easier for you to classify and remember each one of them. This will make it quite easier for you to remember names. Next suggestion from our side to remember names could be to ask the meaning of the name to a few students. Like I had a student named Sinjini and her name had a very wonderful meaning. It meant the sound that anklets make while we walk. And when she described the meaning of her name, it made me remember her name for a very long term. Try this and you never know, you will also remember the name of some student for a really long time. You could also try an activity called Spell It Out, where the kids try and spell their name and you guess the pronunciation. This will also be an interesting activity and the kids will burst into laughter if you spell their names funny. It'll be really amazing. Try it out. If you like today's video, do hit the like button. Comment and tell us the name of your favorite student. Share this with maximum teacher friends and subscribe to Teacherpreneur for more such videos. See you soon.